Let me tell a tale, my child. Hush now, and listen well. How a queen the wrong one scorned, on her daughter the price fell. A beautiful girl, a princess most fair, and a kingdom lost for many a year. Guests for her baptism were picked with care, lest the wicked fairy appear. But she wanted revenge for such an abuse. Uninvited came she with an ominous gift. She shan't live long, the hag cursed and broke loose. A spindle will prick her, in death she shall drift. From fairies came prompt a spell to help out, but the evil was strong and too hard to undo. The worst was averted, but as fate played out, the girl fell asleep, and the kingdom did too. A kiss will save her, one of true love, but many have tried and met their demise. Of that prince, though, pure like a dove, some say he'll go far to prove otherwise.
Hi guys, this is App on Rapper. I'm here with Little Briar Rose. I'm going to show you a walkthrough for the game. So I'm going to start a new game. And I shut the music to make it easier to hear me when I talk. So make sure to come back to this fairy and save frequently, because if you take a break and you don't save, you're going to have to redo parts. It's a little annoying, but just, you know, get into the habit of going back there to save. So come down. So you can't do anything yet here. Let's go down to the gnome village. Talk to them. Okay, so talk to each of them. Okay, so I'll let you watch the tutorial. So let's go find out first what they each want. So he wants a root of a building that's going to look natural and can blend in to the root. So natural, but not like me. Keep talking to them to get as much information as you can. So she looked like spring, and now let's see what the carpenter wants. Foundations raised from the ground. Okay, so now let's go back. We should have all the information we need. You can see them on the side. For some reason, there's some typos, and also the spring one doesn't show up, even though it is important. But let's start with the roof. Should be a mushroom. Not sure what mime tizing is, but okay. Raised and nourishing foundations is going to be the it looks like bamboo and logs. I thought it was the brambles at first, but it's not. The chimney, that's the crow nest proof chimney. Simple but pretty walls. And spring is a flower. So that should do it. Press the check mark. Now, if you got anything wrong, you're going to end up turned into a gnome and replaced by another prince. It's not the end of the world, though. It's actually kind of fun seeing all the different princes. Okay, so now we have the gnome's wish. Okay, so use the gnome's wish on the mushroom. And you need to solve this little labyrinth puzzle. Here's a tutorial. Okay, so you can tap the little green flame if you want to see, if you want to hint to the path. It should help you, but this one's pretty straightforward. Kind of hard to mess this one up. Think that should do it. Yep. Okay, so now we have access to the right path over there. But first, for some reason, this rose here is now accessible. It wasn't before if you tried. But now we have it. Red rose. Okay. Let's go right. Alright, so a merman, pick up the shell here, and come over here to pick this flower. It's a glowing flower. Talk to them, mainly this guy, the king. Okay, so they need a dam. Let's go talk to the gnomes. Okay, so talk to the architect. Okay, so let's go back. We have to talk to the merman and get them to let us. Okay, back to the gnomes. Okay. Okay, before you go, we'll still ask for the saw. Okay. Let's go back up. Use the saw. Oops, use the saw over here. Oh, okay, so not yet. Apparently we need to have a reason for it first. All right. Fishing game. Come over here. Fishing mini game. It's a little frustrating, but you're gonna have to do it a lot. So let's watch the tutorial. So you need to tap and hold, but without letting him get tired. It's a frustrating game, but with practice you should be able to do it pretty well. Alright, here goes. Need to catch 3 big fish plus a whole bunch of other stuff. It can be a little tedious, so bear with me. Hopefully, you can only tap on this line. Don't try doing it anywhere else on the screen. It's not gonna work. Okay, 1 big fish down. Sorry about the noise outside. Okay, so we got a boot. Or an old shoe. Just keep going, you gotta catch everything. Pay close attention to the bar to the left. Oh, you can touch anywhere now. Before it wasn't working. I think that was changed. Used to be, I think, only the bar. But maybe I imagined that. Game got an update since I first played, so I'm not sure if that was changed or just my imagination. Just keep going until you have everything. I think this is the goldfish. I don't even think it ever gets used or even added to your inventory, but it puts up a fight. Oh my god, come on. Yeah, that's the goldfish. I don't think it serves any purpose at all. This should either be a small fish or something else entirely. Okay, claw. Small fish. Alright, shark. This is probably the last one. It's a toughie. Gonna take a while, but do it. You need it. If you don't do it now, you're gonna have to do it later, so just do it now. Alright. Got a shark's tooth. So now if you try again, look what happens. Nothing is biting. So you've caught everything there is to catch. Alright, let's go. Now that we have the three... Now if you try to talk to her now, you can get the gems. Okay, so give her the pincer, or the claws. Now we have some gems. We're gonna need those soon. So let's go back and figure out what his plan was. Wait, what? Oh, right. Okay, so give him the fish. You can't just talk to him. Okay. Okay, so first, it's not just two items. You actually need a trident. Okay, so use the saw to get the branch. And now the carpenter will fix it. Right. Come back, give him the trident. And now talk to him again. You need the symbol of wealth. That's the gems. And the symbol of strength is the shark's tooth. So they all have to wear fish. Okay, yes, we're ready. Okay, before doing this, go back here. And use the fishing rod to get one of these berries. It's an ink berry. Okay. Make sure to save. I'm not, because I'm not planning to stop. Alright. Triton's wish. And now another labyrinth to solve. So come. No, that's not it. I think that should do it. Yep. Okay. Head left to the new area. It's a fairy circle. All right, talk to her. So she needs a detail as bright as the pale light piercing through the treetops in a fresh March morning. You can talk to them. Okay, what you have is a glowing flower, and that's the first item. So, bright and shiny is the reflection on a drop of morning dew at the break of dawn. So you don't have anything like that, but it so happens that the mermaids, or mermen, do. Mermen and mermaids. There's only one mermaid. Okay, so the merman king has shiny scales. Talk to this guy. Okay, so give him the ink berry. Here and wash the scale. Okay, go back to the fairies. Oh, I forgot something. So back here. If you didn't pick it up yet, there's this mirror here. Okay, back to the fairies. And now give her the golden scale. Okay, gold and velvety. So it turns out these flowers are what you need, but she keeps looking at it. So talk to her. She needs a moment to fix her face, so give her the mirror so she can do that. Okay, so now she's distracted and you can pick a flower. Now give her the bellflower. Alright. Need a fruit from the sky. If you try to talk to this bird, he's not gonna. Come over here. Okay, so come here. The right incentive would be a fish. Okay, back to the gnomes. Okay, so we have the cloud. Let's go back. And give her the cloud. So this is the tricky. We have another mini game. What we're gonna need to do, talk to her. Let's watch the tutorial. You have to help them make the dress. So what you need to do is tap on any skulls and crossbones that you see and any Z's that show that they're falling asleep. Leave the light bulbs alone. Those are good ideas. Gets a little hectic at times. And it can be fairly long. That was fast. I didn't get that one. All right, so I didn't get 100 because two of them went really fast, but I still got a 93, and that should be enough. You don't need a perfect score. It'll still be good. So I'm going to say no, it's okay. I don't need 100%. I got it before. It was fine. Okay, Fairy's Wish. Just one more area left after this. So, Fairy's Wish. Sorry about the noise outside. Think that should do it. Yep. Alright, let's head over to the Spriggans. Sorry again, noisy. Alright, talk to them. Talk to this guy specifically. Okay, so the fairy's favorite color. Let's go back. This is a bit of a trickier section. So talk to all the fairies here. So she says green. This one says blue. If you talk to this one, she won't answer. But don't take that as an answer. Keep asking her. Just keep asking her. So the answer is red. It's not 100% clear, but that's the answer. It's the one that you had to pull teeth to get. So go back. So say red. Okay, so this guy is a tailor. So top one, and then again the top one. Okay, so this guy's the cook. Talk to him. Okay, so we have to go to the merman. His guard, not the merman king's guard, not the king himself. So it's this guy over here. Okay, so now you know the helmet is a secret. Talk to this cook again. Okay, so you're gonna have to cook. You have to follow his instructions. So let's follow the tutorial. There's no blowing. That onion. Yes. The royal treat. Okay, give him the recipe. Okay, so a bunch of things to do here. So talk to this guy if you want. He'll give you a poem, but you're not going to use it. All right, let's leave. Talk to the bird. So, flowers. She likes flowers. And you can find... We already have a red flower, the rose. Alright, go to the gnome village. And talk to the painter. Alright, talk to the carpenter and he's going to help you out. Okay, go back. Okay, so butterfly, that's the hint. No, I don't want to listen again. So the butterfly is what you needed to know from there. Let's go up to the merman. We now know two things. Oh, oops, did not mean to do that. Okay, talk to the mermaid. So she gets sick every time she comes. She gets sick when she comes to the lake, so she does not like the lake. So talk to this guy to get a poem. All right. So again, if you want to hear it again, but you don't have to. Okay. Talk to this guy again to confirm that you need a flower. Okay, so you now should have all the information you need. And we're gonna go play Cyrano to this guy. Okay, so now you have to use all the information you learned. So suggest the Merman's poem. So give her the red flower. So she doesn't like the lake shake, it makes her sick. So dinner at my place. And she likes the butterfly, so you're going to talk about insects. Alright, Spriggan's Wish. Almost done with the game. So this one's a little more tricky, a little trickier than the others. As it should be. Spriggan's Wish. Alright. So. I think that should be it, yes. A maze champion. Okay. So you now have access to the castle. Alright, let's go up to the castle. And here's the thing, if at any point you failed and got replaced by a different prince, then you're not going to be able to break the curse right now. So, you need to be this prince in order to break the curse. So, I'm not showing you this part, but if you got replaced by any other princes, then you can try to kiss her. It's going to fail, so then you go back down, and the fairy will meet you and tell you that you need to turn the other princes back from their gnome, fish, or fairy shapes. So, you have to go fetch them. And carry them to the fountain in the castle grounds. So you can ignore all of them and just grab the first guy who's a gnome. He should be a gnome, I assume. He might be something else if you... I'm not sure messed up, if that affects the shape that he turns into. But anyway, it should eventually... You need to get this guy back. He has to be the one to kiss the princess. And that's it. You saved Aurora. And that's the end of Little Briar Rose. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, please subscribe to my channel. Thanks, bye-bye.